Hello everyone, myself Amita Mahisuri. Today we are going to study Business Studies, Chapter 2, Part 1, Taylor's Principles of Scientific Management. Dear students, we have given a link at the last of the video which is related to the topics which you are going to study in this video. And these games, the link of these games you can note down and then you can search in the Google. You'll get the games and you can get the marks as you want. So let us start with this chapter 2, Taylor's Principles of Scientific Management. F.W. Taylor was the pioneer who put forward scientific principles of management. As a result of his keen research in different areas of individuality or activity, he realized the weaknesses of traditional method. He said that the traditional method of the business was so weak, this method was so weak that it was incurring losses and wastage of the resources. So he said that it is necessary to apply some scientific principles to the management so that this wastage of the resources should be avoided. He realized the weaknesses of traditional methods and consequently tried to apply a logical approach. He said that a logical approach towards the solving of management problem should be applied. Taylor, who worked in different capacities in the mining industry, saw the urgent necessity for elimination of wastage which was rampant in industrial organization. He said that in all the industrial organization, before applying this scientific principles of management, there were lots of wastage of resources as well as the cost were very, very high. Now, let us see what is scientific management then. Scientific management implies application of science to management. It means the conduct of business activities through standardized tools and methods and use of trained personnel. He said that any activity, any business activity should conduct with the help of standardized tools, methods and use of trained personnel, means trained people. It helps, how it is going to help the business? It helps to increase output, reduce cost and wastage and improve the quality of output. So, dear students, let us study some of the principles which are given by F.W. Taylor. So, the first principle here is science, not rule of thumb. He said that the rule of thumb methods are traditional approaches that suited organizations in the past. Means in the past, these method, rule of thumb method was suited, means it was implemented by the organization in the past. But now, under mass production, the volume of work had expanded that required scientific methods to manage and control work easily. Accordingly, Taylor suggested that methods of a particular business activity should be scientifically studied prior to their application to avoid mistakes. He said that it is necessary that any method before applying in the business activity, it should be studied scientifically. If this method is proved to be perfect to apply, then only they should apply in the business so that they can avoid the mistakes. He suggested introducing standardized and guaranteed approaches that led to efficiency in operations. If they are going to introduce standardized and guaranteed approaches by studying all these approaches or methods scientifically, it will obviously give them perfection and efficiency in the operations of business. For example, a textile factory consists of 150 workers and there are 5 different units within this factory. These units are spinning, weaving, stitching, adding buttons and embroidery. Each of these units was assigned with a specialist foreman. This specialist foreman is specialist in this particular task. For example, a foreman who is specialist in spinning, another is specialist in weaving, another in stitching, another in buttons, adding buttons, and another in embroidery. These specialist foreman who has knowledge and experience regarding that particular activity should be assigned to each units. There will be 5 specialist foremen who will be assigned with 30 workers. Now under this foreman who are the specialist in this different task, they are being given 30 workers, each distributed among 5 business units. And these 30 workers which are assigned to a particular foreman is also having idea related to the work given to them. So this way, when the work is being divided among these people, the particular specialist person can manage these 30 workers, they can maintain the discipline, they can solve the problems of these 30 workers, and the work can be done under him with more efficiently and effectively. Second point that he gave is harmony, not discord. He said that the harmony between the workers and management is necessary. He said that there should be mutual cooperation and coordination. He said that workers should not be overburdened with work, while should not feel dissatisfied with their investment of time and money in an organization. He said that workers who are working in the business activities or in the business, they should not feel overburdened that they are given more work than the time invested by them or the money given to them in the organization. According to Taylor, a firm can achieve maximum prosperity if workers and management work with each other, leading to development of a cordial relationship with each other. He said that any institution can achieve maximum prosperity only if workers and management, they work with each other and they have cordial relationship between each other, which will again help them to maintain the team spirit, and they can achieve organizational goals very easily. For example, workers are assigned with work by one superior, like a functional foreman. These superiors are allocated separate bureaucratic powers. Bureaucratic powers means some of the authority, and can divide a particular activity in several tasks depending upon the complexity of the activity. If the process, activity means the process, if so vast that some few people cannot attend it on time, then the work should be divided among several groups. They act as, now these superiors, after dividing the work to the people under him, they act as disciplinarians which maintain discipline among the employees, mediators during disputes. Whenever there is dispute among the employees or related to any problem, they are the mediators who can approach to their superiors to solve the disputes and review workers' performance. They even find out how the workers are working in the institution. Such relationship between workers and superiors is necessary as it creates harmony and avoids confusion along with conflict. So these supervisors who are assigned, these are considered as the mediator between the workers and the superiors, and these mediators helps to create harmony and avoid confusion among between both the management and workers. Now the third principle which is given by him is cooperation, not individualism. This point is the continuation of the earlier point which we have studied. Here he said it is coordination, not individualism, that will assist in achieving organizational goals. He said that every person who is working in any institution, they should feel that they are supposed to work in cooperation and coordination with other people to achieve a particular goal, maybe the individual goal or the organizational goal. They should not feel only the benefits of himself. They should not have that idea in the mind. Cooperation is an action of working together, and Taylor states employees and management should cooperate with each other that could lead to high moral and team spirit. He said that both management and the employees should have good cooperation, which will give them high moral and team spirit. In the earlier example on harmony between workers and superiors, workers are expected to cooperate and undertake responsibility and accountability for completion of work. Here it is said that the workers should work in such a way by taking the responsibilities given to them that they complete the work on time with more efficiency without wasting the resources. As soldering led to underwork and individualism, Taylor observed that factories endured excessive cost and wastage of resources. He said, if every individual person is given independency to work as per their wish, then it can lead to individualism and underwork. And he even observed that such factories have excessive cost and wastage of resources. So they should be having not individualism but cooperation among them. The fourth point, that is development of each and every person to his or her greatest efficiency and prosperity. He said, Taylor suggested that all possible human efforts should be utilized maximally, leading to efficiency and prosperity for the workers and the business. He said that whatever human being they have employed, their efforts should be utilized maximally, which will lead to the efficiency and prosperity for both workers and the business. This means that workers with suitable skills and capabilities should be fittingly considered for certain activities in an organization. Even he said that the worker should be given that work in which he is having more capabilities or he is having more skills, so that he can do his work in a more efficient way, which will be helping the organization in a best way. This also means that workers should be employed for specific and specialized activities that possibly requires minimum efforts and eliminates errors and wastage of resources. Even he said that the workers who are being assigned some work, these work should be related to the skill or the degree he has in which he is specialized, so that he has to put less efforts and minimum errors and wastage of resources. For example, here it is given, a well-built worker who can carry, means who is having more strength, who can carry a certain load or weight, should be given the responsibility to carry gunny bags of products into the firm. Means whoever is capable to carry heavy load, they should be given heavy load to do the work. A weak build with no experience or idea about carrying any load, but relevant experience in a certain field like accounting, is given a specific job like an accountant that involves minimum manual work. Means the person who don't have that build, his body is that weak, but he is having experience in certain fields like accounting, he should be given the work, specific job related to his field. Now, fifth one is mental revolution. The workers and managers should have a complete change of outlook towards their mutual relation and work effort. It requires that management should create suitable working condition and solve all problems scientifically. He said that management should take care of the workers, their condition, working condition, and they should be always available to solve every problem scientifically. Similarly, workers should attend their jobs with utmost attention, devotion and carefulness. He said that workers should also apply their duties. They should also do their duties relevantly. They should also put their attention to the work, devoted to the work, and be very careful to the work. They should not waste the resources of enterprise. Handsome remuneration should be provided to the workers to boost up their morale. It is necessary that whoever is working with more efforts, with good efforts and their capability to have benefits, to get the benefits or to achieve the goal of the organization, they should be given handsome remuneration. Remuneration means wages or salary, so that they will be given high morale, or they will feel good and do hard work for the institution. They will be disciplined, loyal and sincere in fulfilling the tasks assigned to them. Now, the sixth point he gave is maximum prosperity for employer and employees. The aim of scientific management is to see maximum prosperity for employer and employees. It is important only when there is opportunity for each worker to attain his highest efficiency. The maximum output and optimum utilization of resources will bring higher of profits for the employer and better wages for the workers. Both managers and workers should be paid handsomely. He said that it is necessary to employ scientific management so that they can have maximum prosperity both for employer and employees, and they can reduce the wastage of resources and have optimum utilization of resources, so they both can get handsome payment. So thank you everyone. These were some of the principles of scientific management given by the Taylor. Now, dear student, these links which are given here, these links are related to the games. Now, these games include find the words, drag the words, fill ups, MCQs, true or false. So, you can copy down or note down these links and find out in the Google. You will get exactly all these whatever I have given above. And if you have studied this video or you have paid attention to this video, you will definitely get the answers. So, thank you everyone. All the best again.